Good evening, everyone. So today we will be talking about the future of containers in OpenStack. So OpenStack has evolved a lot to support containers in its ecosystem. So there has been several projects which are trying to support containers as same as they do with VMs today. So we'll briefly talk about, this is the agenda for our presentation today. So we'll talk about what are the containers, container-related projects in OpenStack, and how are they trying to support containers in OpenStack ecosystem. So, and then we'll talk about Zun in detail, because we are trying to focus more on Zun, as we all are the core developers in Zun. And we'll talk about the architecture of Zun, what are the services in OpenStack which Zun integrates with. We are trying to integrate with all OpenStack services to take advantage of all the projects. And then the Zun features, and finally we'll show a demo of running an application on OpenStack ecosystem using Zun. So OpenStack is overall an integration project which tries to integrate all the technologies that are available for cloud computing. So of course it's come same for the containers. So containers evolved in many years back. So in 2014, OpenStack felt the importance of supporting containers the same they do for VMs today. So there has been several projects in OpenStack which are trying to support containers. So some of the projects are using containers to make the OpenStack operations simpler, while some of the projects are trying to let users run container on OpenStack ecosystem. So these are a few of the projects like which are trying to let you help like to run containers on OpenStack ecosystem. So I have tried to list some of the projects. So first is the Nova Docker. So Nova Docker started as entry project with Nova. Nova was like simply a Docker hypervisor driver for Nova. So users can run containers the same way they run a VM using the Nova. So you just say Nova boot and gives the image for your container. It will run the containers on the same level where you run your VMs. But then VMs and containers are not same. So they decided to fork it to a new project. So that's how Nova Docker was started. And eventually, because it does not suit the life cycle of VM, so then this project expired this year itself. So after that, there has been several projects which are trying to let you run your containers on OpenStack ecosystem. So the Heat Docker is the second project. Heat Docker provides you heat resource for the for container. It lets you run containers on OpenStack ecosystem. You just have to specify, write a template for your OpenStack for containers. For example, you say, I just want to create, for example, Nginx servers. You provide the details of those image in your Heat template, and you specify where your Docker is running. So the Heat will run your application on any kind of infrastructure which you want. So advantage of using Heat Docker is like you have the options of running your containers inside VM or any bare metal node. So the next project is Magnum. It was founded in 2014. Like it aimed on providing support for containers, and it tried to enable containers as a first class resource in OpenStack. So it started with supporting Kubernetes. Today it supports various other kind of container orchestration engine. Some of them are like Kubernetes, Mesos, and Swarm. So what Magnum does is it helps you run Kubernetes, Mesos, and Swarm cluster on OpenStack ecosystem. So it also supports both VM and bare metal. So for example, you can use Magnum to run your Kubernetes cluster on OpenStack VMs or bare metals. So similarly, it supports Swarm and Mesos as well. So initially, it aimed on managing containers on OpenStack ecosystem, but then it went in a different direction, and today it's managing only the infrastructure for containers. It means you, after you deploy your Kubernetes cluster or any other CoE cluster, you can use the native CLIs to run your containers on this infrastructure backed by different technologies. The next project is Murano. Murano is the application catalog for OpenStack. Murano supports various applications, so Kubernetes is one of them. So it has a ready application like Docker applications. You can just go to Murano UI and you will be able to see these kind of applications on Murano. So it lets you run any kind of application on just a click. So it is very simpler. You just don't have to worry about all the configuration at the banks. Murano handles all the configurations by itself, and you'll get a production-ready applications on the Murano UI. So it's just a click away for your any kind of applications Murano have. So the projects which I talked about earlier are those projects which are trying to let you run containers on OpenStack. And these are a few of the projects which are using Docker or Docker to make OpenStack operations simpler. So for example, like Cola has production ready container images which you can use to run your OpenStack cluster on any kind of infrastructure. So for example, if you want to run, for example, Magnum or any other OpenStack services, you have the container images on Cola, you can use that, and you'll have a production-ready OpenStack environment. So it really eases the operation of OpenStack cluster. It lets you do the upgrade. It simplifies the upgrade and scale up and scale down. So Cola provides you the production-ready container images for OpenStack services. The next project is Courier. So Courier is trying to provide the container, the networking for the container resources. It means it uses the Neutron API to provide the same resources that are available for VMs also. So for example, if you provide the driver as Courier in Docker, Courier will talk to Neutron to provide all these resources, and you can have your containers and VMs on the same network, and using Courier, your container can talk to the VMs under the OpenStack ecosystem. So it helps you, like the interaction between a VM and a container, a VM and a bare metal node, this kind of communication is possible using Courier project. So finally, I would like to like talk about Zune. So Zune, in Austin Summit, when Magnum team met and decided that we are not going to support container endpoints anymore because they wanted to focus more on the infrastructure. So they decided to fork a new project. That's how Zune evolved, and it is now called the Container Service of OpenStack. It provides you APIs to manage your containers on OpenStack. So it has many APIs that you can find in other container technologies as well. So it you can use the Zune APIs to run your container applications on OpenStack infrastructure. So we aim to support like various container runtimes. So we started with Docker. So we today have very good support of Docker in Zune. And we also aim to support other container runtimes like Rocket, Clear Containers, other, etc. And we also aim to integrate with Kubernetes Docker Swarm. Like we will be providing some set of APIs that you can use to interact to run your Kubernetes applications on OpenStack infrastructure. This is the architecture of Zune. So Zune mainly have two services, the Zune API and the Zune Compute. And for example, when you say create a container for me, so Zune API forwards that request to Zune Compute. We also support multiple compute in Zune today. So we have a very simple scheduler in Zune that picks up the compute host where your container would be running. So after that, the Zune interacts with either Glance or the Docker Hub to download your image. So after the image is downloaded on the compute host, it talks to the Docker to create your container. So then Docker talks to Courier for the networking resource. Courier sends a request to Neutron to provide the resources. So after this, you'll have a running container that is on the same network as your OpenStack Nova VMs are running. So the communication between a container and VM is possible using Courier. So this is just a detailed thing which I have explained just now. It's just that we have the Zune API. Zune API interacts with the Zune compute after scheduler picks up a compute host where our container will be running. And then Zune compute talks to Neutron to provide the list of available networks. We provide that, we create a network, with that network, we talk to Courier to create a network in Docker. Finally, after that, we create a container with that network, which was created by Courier. So, and then the container is created, we say Neutron to do the port binding for us. So after that, we'll have a completely full-fledged application running on OpenStack ecosystem. Okay, so now Namrata will explain how to use Zune CLI to run your applications on OpenStack ecosystem.
We will see that how we will run containers through Zune. So there are two containers underlying the same network. One is WordPress, that is web server container, and another is MySQL, that is a DB container. So what we are doing, that we have to interact between the MySQL container and WordPress container. So they are interacting with the IP address. So you can see the first command, Zune run, what it is doing, that it is setting the environment variables, then using the image. Then the second command, the WordPress web server, it is setting the IP, it is searching for the IP address of the other container which we want to access, and then setting the environment variables and the image. Then they can interact with the IP address which we have given to them, which it has fetched. Now orchestration with heat. It is doing the same thing which we did earlier, but it is doing with the heat template. Here we are setting the two resources. One is DB, that is MySQL, and another one is WordPress. The type of resource is OS Zune container. We have set the properties, the image MySQL, and environment variables we have set here. And for the web, WordPress, that is web server container, we have set the environment variable. We are fetching the IP address of the container we want to communicate with. So it will fetch the IP address of the container and communicate with that container. Now we will see how Zune has integrated with other OpenStack services. They are Keystone. Keystone provides the authentication support for Zune. So to access Zune API, users should be registered with Keystone. Glance, Zune uses Glance to manage container images. Heat, we use Heat template to run our application through Heat template. OpenStack client, it supports Zune commands. Horizon, we has a Horizon UI plugin in Zune. You can use browser to manage your applications through Zune. Neutron and Courier, Zune supports Neutron and Courier, and it helps in communicating between the two containers, our container and Nova VMs. Cinder, we can attach storage to Zune containers through Cinder. This is the diagram which shows the integration with other OpenStack services. We have seen the Keystone for authentication, images through Glance, storage for Cinder, and network through Neutron. We are planning to integrate with Magnum so we can orchestrate containers on different technology COEs, Kubernetes, Docker, or Docker's Swarms. Zune features, this is the list of Zune features which Zune is providing. first zone provides a container API so that users can interact with containers. A container host management zone is zone manages set of container host and resources, and like other OpenStack projects, container resources are isolated by keystone tenants. Neutron integration, as we have seen earlier, zone is integrated with Neutron. And it supports multiple container image repositories. So we can fetch images from Docker Hub or Glance. It is integrated with Heat. We can use Heat template to orchestrate containers. Horizon integration. Zune has Horizon UI plugin. So we can use browser to manage the application. OpenStack client integration. We have OpenStack client, we support Zune commands through OpenStack client. Now Shushan will demonstrate the present presentation which is on a VM which is provided by Nginx server and running on a container inside a Zune container.
Next. No, it's not going, it's not working.
You are seeing that Mate desktop on Ubuntu VM in Horizon's console view. This VM has HTML-based presentation player powered by Libio.js. It contains static HTML, style sheet, and JavaScript files, and files are at local on VM. The presentation player is customized to load its contents from external Markdown file. The Markdown file content should be provided by HTTP, but it has not been provided yet. So this player can't play the presentation. This VM is located on private network for demo project. And has IP address 10.0.0.10. So let's provide content for the presentation from container inside private network. You are seeing Zune UI plugged into Horizon. This panel is added into project menu for users. Let me create container to provide presentation contents. Presentation contents provider for container name. And in this case, use Nginx container image, Docker Alpine Nginx. Set command bin bash, and this container will start after created. Also, we can specify number of CPU, memory size, working directory, environment variables. Interactive mode will enable should TTY and standard in-out. Also, enable to access from web console via web sockets. And can specify labels to the container and click create. Create container request is accepted successfully. And Zoom UI has actions to operate almost features of Zoom. Start, stop, reboot, pause and pause, execute command, send kill signal, and delete container. Container will be created and started soon. Next, set contents of presentation using console. Create web root directory. And create contents file in Markdown using printf command. Then run nginx. Okay, nginx has started. To confirm network settings for this container, change tab to overview. And to service nginx, 443 and 80 ports are exposed. And we can see this container has IP address as 10.0.0.8. Please remember the IP address 10.0.0.8 for this container. In the network panel, we can see ports for router 10.0.0.1, DHCP 10.0.0.2, and Ubuntu VM 10.0.0.10. In private subnet. After reload this panel, then port for the container will exist. New port exists. This IP address 10.0.0.8 is same as you saw in Zoom UI. And this port is created by clear driver by a neutron. To access this port via HTTP, the rule has already added to default security group for this demo project. Also, ICMP protocols are added, and it will allow to access Nginx on the container from VM. To confirm networking, let me ping between VM and container each other. Container has 10.0.0.8 and VM has the 10.0.0.10. IP address. At first, ping to VM from container using web console. Ping 5 times to VM 10.0.0.10. Got response from VM. Next, ping to container from VM using terminal. Ping 5 times to container 10.0.0.8. Got response from container. So now we confirm networking between VM and container via ICMP. Before accessing container from VM via HTTP, let's watch access log for Nginx on container. Switch view to console of container using tail command. Watch access log for Nginx. If the Nginx will be accessed, the new access log will be added here. Let's change to VM, and it's time to access container from VM to load Markdown contents for this presentation player. Now, load contents from container 10.0.0.8 and play presentation. Okay, success. Finally, the presentation player got contents from container. We can confirm the HTTP access in the access log for Nginx from VM 10.0.0.10. As you see, Zoom works with Neutron and Clear in container networking. And like VM, we can operate containers provided by Zoom. That's all for demo. Thank you for listening.
Okay, thank you everyone. So we are done with the presentation. If you have any questions, feel free to ask us. Like, we do have time for our Q&A round. Okay, so tomorrow we have a operators feedback session for Zoom as well. So if you have any use case or any kind of question, please feel free to come and join us. We'll be happy to answer any kind of questions. Thank you, everyone.